Hello, Calgary! As spring approaches, I'm getting ready for the onslaught of rain just ready to happen. But we really don't see much rain in spring, huh? Rainy season begins during the Stampede. But that's alright, because no one will be rained on their parade for 6 Stampede concert ticket giveaways we're doing. Call in right now and answer questions to win some sick tickets. Oh wow, we already have a caller, putting them on the line now.
Wow, hello?
Wow, hey, you're our first caller. So, to win these sick tickets, you're gonna have to answer these questions that I'm gonna ask about how you promote your culture in Calgary.
Wow, perfect. I'm actually a francophone, so I can really resonate to this question.
Wow, sick.
Okay, well, as a francophone in Calgary, I was really limited when speaking French around the city. It was really hard to adapt in the workplace as well, which is why I had to learn English. It's really hard to keep my identity in Calgary as a francophone when everyone is anglophone here.
Huh, that's really brutal.
Yeah, English is so dominant. I barely speak French anymore. Even online, it's really hard to find any francophone communities. But thanks to Canada's cultural content laws that require 60% of programming on Canadian TV stations to be Canadian, I'm able to listen and watch a lot of francophone content. And not only that, this Quebec Cinema Act requires filmmakers to produce their films in Quebec. And I love it. Quebec movies are the bomb.com.
Yeah, they are. These cultural content laws created by the Canadian Radio, Television, and Telecommunications Commissions really help affirm francophone identity. I love Quebec movies.
Oh yeah, speaking of francophone content, things like the Francophone Summit really encourage my kids to love being French in an English-dominated city by hosting these amazing events to advocate for francophones in a globalizing world.
Wow, that's so sweet. Well, thanks for sharing your story. You won some sick tickets to see Smash Mouth live in concert.
Wow, thanks. I love Smash Mouth. I'm a believer. You know what they say. Je déteste ma vie.
Okay, that's enough. Wow, we're already getting another caller.
Hello.
Hi, it's Ariel, your favorite radio host. You're our special second caller.
Oh my god, wow. I'm a big fan.
Okay, well, thanks. Me too.
Okay.
Anyways, how do you affirm your identity in Calgary?
No, sick. I actually recently participated in that Safe Chinatown thing. I love being Chinese.
Okay.
I think that Chinatown is a big part of my Chinese identity in Calgary, so I was really upset about being overshadowed by a condo. A bunch of us all went out and protested it, so hopefully everything works out.
I hope so.
Yeah, the monuments in the basement museum of the Chinese Cultural Center revitalize the Asian community in Calgary downtown. There's like statues of terracotta warriors and ancient clothing worn by emperors.
There's a museum?
Yeah, it's been there for like so many years, dude.
Yeah, I heard about UNESCO, the largest international organization that promotes cultural diversity, and how it has a program that preserves cultural masterpieces to be passed on to future generations.
Okay, well, it really revitalizes my culture for the people who visit it. To be fair, we don't promote it very much.
You know what? I think it's just me being dumb.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's sick. Thanks for calling in. You've won sick tickets to see AHA live in concert.
Is that the guy who sang Africa?
No, that's Toto. AHA sang the Take On Me.
Oh, sick. I love AHA. I'm probably his biggest fan.
Okay, that's enough.
Okay, sorry. See ya. Thanks. Bye.
Okay, well, we only have time for one more caller. Let's make it count, y'all.
Hello? Oh my god, is this real life?
Yeah, it is! You're talking to Ariel, best radio host around!
Wait, I think I have the wrong number.
Wait, no, don't play me like this. Don't you want free concert tickets?
Is this a scam?
Please just answer these questions. How do you promote your cultural identity in Calgary?
Okay, well, I don't live in Calgary, but I'm actually an Aboriginal person.
Wait. That's so cool!
I guess it's pretty aight. I'm from a smaller nation, and our language is actually kinda dying.
How so?
I mean, a lot of people just don't want to learn it anymore. With a globalizing world, Why learn such a small First Nation language when you can learn something more prominent like English?
Well, I guess you're right. But everyone has the linguistic right to choose what they want to speak.
Yeah. But with the Declaration of Rights on Indigenous People, I hope we can see the change.
What's that?
Oh, the Declaration? It's aiming to affirm diverse rights regarding lands, territories, and resources that are essential to the cultural identities of Indigenous people and the fulfillment of their basic human rights.
Wow, that's really cool.
Yeah, with the help of from the Assembly of First Nation, I hope we can achieve these rights.
Wow, me too, dude. Hope for the best, you know?
I guess.
Okay, well, if you ever come to Calgary, you've won free tickets to see Toto live in action.
Is that the guy who's saying, "Take on me"?
No, that's Aha.
I poured my heart out, and you can't even give me tickets to Aha?
Wait, I'm sorry, dude.
No, it's fine. Whatever, dude.
Thanks to everyone who called in. This is actually sponsored by the Canadian government. As you can see from the people who called in, Canada really is a multicultural country. Did you guys know that we were the first country to adopt multiculturalism as an official government policy? As the stampede approaches, don't forget to celebrate Multiculturalism Day on June 27th. Quoting the wise words of Michelle John, let's build on the strengths of our diversity and on dialogue, rather than become mired in the clash of cultures. We'll be back after this short commercial break.